Hello everyone, I'm Safia Fatima and I'm doing my second year in Bachelor of Computer Science Engineering in CEG Anna University. On behalf of the Gindi Times, the official campus magazine of CEG, ACT and SAT, I present to you the COVID-19 Survivor Series, an initiative which aims at bringing about a positive impact during this pandemic. Today we have with us one such COVID survivor. So now, where do you suspect you got the virus?
Good evening, everyone. So, it was around September 18th. So, I went out to get my repaired laptop, which was given 1 week ago. So, I think that's where I got it. Maybe that's where I got the virus impact. And I don't know because I'm not sure. Because 2 days after, my brother and my father went out for grocery shopping. Maybe that's where, I don't know which, I'm not sure which say where they got to suspect the virus, but I think most probably when I went out for laptop or any other, I got a virus.
Right, okay now. So, you must have felt some symptoms, right, which made you get checked out, checked out for the virus. So, what did you feel now?
So, to be honest, I got a headache on Tuesday evening. The next day morning, Wednesday morning, I got a heavy headache, fever and cold as well. So I thought it's just from a normal fever, but the next day my brother also got a fever and cold. 2 days later my mother also had a dry cough and fever. So my mother is a sugar patient and also BP, has more BP, so that's why we thought it's better that we take a test. So we took a test on Saturday and Sunday morning the results came. 3 of us got tested positive. The good news is my father got negative. So that's
what. Now, after you got tested positive, what did it feel like for you to be a patient of the virus?
Felt a bit disappointed, first of all, to be honest. Because we are more careful for more than 6 months. Unluckily, we got the virus, but I was feeling more confident that we could able to fought and recover because I know I'm engaged, so I know I could be recovered, but I was feeling sad for my mother because she had sugar and deep, as I said. So after I got the virus, straight away the doctor advised to take a CT scan to know how much virus has affected in the lungs and chest. We booked an ambulance and we went to the scan center, and after we take the scan and report, the report was looking normal for pre-office.
That's really good now. So now when you were under treatment, what were the medications and other things that helped you the most?
I think we had a family doctor who known us for more than 10 years. So when I got fever on Wednesday, we straight away contacted doctor, and general medicines which were given for COVID patients like zinc tablets, Clarivate, Ibuprofen. So these are tablets that were given. Additionally, I did the natural medicines like Cabosulfurini and gargling with gargling water. I did 5 times a day, so which had a major impact on me, and also steam, like it, I don't know whether it will seem Tamil, Ibuprofen solvangla. So I also did 3-2 times a day. So that's what I think I quickly recovered, maybe a week after I got fever on Tuesday. I got fever on Wednesday. I got recovered on Monday. Monday, fever and cold both were gone.
That's really good to hear now. So when you were tested positive, and in that period between Wednesday and Monday, how were you able to cope with the virus mentally now?
I think I felt, and 2 days later only, I know it's going to be COVID because Tuesday evening, I had a headache. Wednesday morning, I had a fever. So I just thought maybe it might be COVID or it might be normal fever. But the next day, my brother got fever. I felt, okay, this is COVID, but that's for sure. So I was being quarantined in my room itself, so I didn't go out. I used my window in my bedroom to this attached bathroom, so I didn't go out for 3-4 days from my room itself. So yeah, which was a bit depressed, to be honest. But I used to get to it, to be honest. I used to chat with my friends. So yeah, I coped up with it, and yeah.
That's really positive to hear. Now, when you had the virus, which moment would you consider to be the most scariest moment for you personally?
Well, for me, there's nothing like that. Two things that made me scared. When I got positive, and also my mother got positive. So I felt a bit worried for my mother because she is having sugar and BP because it's an Irish factor. So, but she got fever and cough were reduced within 2-3 days for my mother. The second thing is my brother, elder brother. When he took the CT scan, his lungs were a bit affected. Very small factor of virus were affecting his lungs. But doctors said the virus could be recovered because medicines and home treatment could be fine. But 2 days, his fever also is gone. But after that, his fever and cough continued to increase. And at the same time, his pulse also got to increase. I remember checking his pulse. It was around 155. I was in a big shock, to be honest. So doctor, we again contacted doctor and he asked to take a CT scan again. But this time, I think the CT scan he took only for my brother. I think it was worse, to be honest. The virus got affected off of his lungs. And I think doctor said it's better to get admitted in the hospital. Well, we were thinking whether we got to go or not, but I think this the time there's no choice. So my brother got admitted in Sims Hospital. So when it was on Saturday evening, my brother was just going down. An ambulance came from Sims Hospital. Three people with PPE kit, they were just wearing, and well, he was just like a prisoner was going. I just don't know what to say because I can't control my tears at that moment. It was really so scary and really so emotional, to be honest.
Now, how is your yes, now?
My brother is fine actually. Saturday night he was admitted. Now it's discharged Friday evening for discharge. Doctor said still need some. He will have to be quarantined for more than 10 days. He's fine now. He looks a bit tired. Fever, cough, everything is fine now. He looks a bit tired. It's going to take some time, to be honest.
Yes, now. Praying for your brother's speedy recovery now. So, yes. After this experience now, which was nothing short of critical, do you feel any noticeable changes in your daily mindset and your perspective and general outlook towards life?
Well, I think yes, for sure. I think take for example my father. First day he got negative, but he was in contact with me. When I got fever and cough, he was also in contact with my brother. He was also in contact with my mother, but till now, he didn't get any symptoms. To be honest, he didn't get any symptoms till now. Why? Because of the food he has been taking for the past 20 years or 30 years from childhood till now. I think his age is 62 actually. He was taking good food, good healthy food, good natural foods. That was made him a big strong person. So I think I need to take some more food just like him, and that's what I need to eat, more natural foods. And at the same time, after post-COVID, I think if you want to see difference between pre-COVID and post-COVID, post-COVID you would get so much tired. That's the truth actually. Many people would say, I'm getting more tired, to be honest. Now I used to eat 3 times a day. Generally, everyone used to eat 3 times a day. Sleeping this afternoon and at night times. But I get sleepy 3 times. So that's what it is. I think tired will happen. Doctors said to me, tiredness will be there for at least 15 days. So I think you have to get recovered. So even after COVID, I think there's still some, what to say, side effects like this. tiredness you will have.
Right now, I hope you recover fast now. So last up, what is the message that you want to share with those watching about your experience now?
Well, my message is this COVID, if we, my our age people only should watch it. I'll just give a message. So this COVID-19 will affect you mentally when compared to physically. That's the truth. Because in our age, I think you will be recovered soon enough. But if you get virus for your parents or for your elder brother who is a bit weak, I think it's going to be scary. That's what the truth is. So be mentally prepared. And just if you got a virus, small fever or cold, also you'll be a bit scared, to be honest, from now on itself. Until this pandemic ends, even if you have a normal cold or normal cough, I think you would get scary, whether it's COVID or not. So mentally, you have to be prepared. And at the same time, if you get virus, please don't be worried or scared. You will be fine, that's for sure. Just be confident. Whenever you're feeling depressed or sad, just talk to your best friend. I just want to say one more thing. I had a best friend who used to talk to me daily. I don't want to mention the name. That friend used to talk to me daily for minimum 15 to 20 minutes. That really helped me to recover from mental depression. So that friend was there for me. So you just need to have a good friend or good reference who used to call or speak to you daily, which gives you a motivation to get recovered soon first. And finally, eat healthy foods like fruit or like kanji in Sulwanga. I don't know what is saying this thing. Eat, drink lots of kanji andamari. Just eat healthy foods. You will be fine in future also. And get more immunity.
That's really very correctly said na. Romba thanks na ipa ninga time odiki vandadukku. And yeah na, so that's all. Thank you na.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks na.